the daughter of Nani, our largest and oldest animal. She weighs around 515 pounds. She is 41 years old.
That's
pretty old, actually. It's really great considering lifespan for a dolphin is typically 25 to 30 years. So we're pretty thrilled about that. Now I wanted to tell you a little bit about our day because we're going to meet our male dolphins in just a little bit when the trainers join us. So a lot of you were asking me how you get to be a dolphin trainer. And if you're interested in that, I'll definitely help you out after the presentation. But I wanted to talk to you a little bit about what we do once we're here and from a day-to-day basis. I know it looks like a lot of fun playing with the animals all day, but it's actually a lot of work. Our day begins at 6:30 every morning, sorting through about 250 pounds of frozen fish. So if that sounds like fun to you, come and talk to me and show you how you can do that. And then throughout the day, we're not only doing a lot of work with the animals, we're also working to keep this area nice and tidy, nice and clean, doing behind the scenes programs. We're lifting 30 pound flats of frozen fish. We're scrubbing these pools. In fact, one of us is in this pool pretty much once a day for about an hour scrubbing. So as you can imagine, it's a very physical job. Looks like they're ready to start. But in addition to all that manual stuff you don't really get to see, we're also obviously working with the animals. Now, it's not only our job as trainers to train all the fun behaviors you guys are familiar with, like splashing, leaping, anything like that. It's also important for us to train behaviors that's going to help us help the animals. So we're going to talk about that today. Those are behaviors called husbandry behaviors. So in the meantime, I need to make a special announcement. Any 49ers fans we have, if you're just making your way down to the splash zone, that would be great. No? I see you over there. I see you. Ultrasound equipment to actually a really easy place for us to find veins if we need a blood sample. Very good. All right. Good job, Foster. Go back and get some fish. Give Rowan a round of applause for being so brave. Excellent job. Now, in addition to doing things like ultrasounds and blood samples, it's also important for us to get a visual look at our animals each and every morning. So our trainers are going to make their way down to the windows. We're going to show you something that we do every day. It's called a visual check. We actually have some more volunteers that are going to help us out at these windows. If you're sitting in the center section, take a look up on the screens. We're going to have all the action up there for you. Looks like Tom's going to come down here. Now, like I said, every morning when we step up to the animals for the first time, it's important for us to give them a once over. Just look at them, see how their general overall health and appearance is. So down here at the windows, you guys are going to get to see exactly what that entails. So first and foremost, a little circle there, when they pop up, we're going to take a look inside of their mouths. And that's really important because dolphins do have a lot of teeth. In fact, they have 88 to 100 cone-shaped, very sharp teeth. So as trainers, we're just taking a look inside that mouth, make sure it looks nice and clean and healthy. Beautiful cheese smile there. He's going to come up on the glass. As you can see, it's a good way to kind of get an idea of what's going on inside the animal. Talk to flip them around a little bit. Now, another really important way to kind of look at the animal's overall health is to see how they are behaviorally. So we're actually going to ask them a couple of hand signals to see how quickly they respond. Let's watch.
Ready to stand up.